Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The Fall of the Usurper, which I found in the Jubiline Cloister, though it most likely was a random drop. The Fall of the Usurper. The people of Dwinin celebrate Uthrochtide every fifth of Sun's Dawn, the date when, according to legend, a man emerged from the wilderness of Hyrok and defeated the undead of Castle Whitemore to become the first Baron of Dwinin. Few people believe the legend anymore, but there most certainly was a Baron Uthroch of Dwinin who is destined to become one of the true heroes of Hyrok, if not all Tamriel. The legend, as most any Dwinin child will tell you, is that years and years ago, archivists have agreed to the year Third Era, 253, the people of Dwinin were ruled by a lich and its armies of zombies, ghosts, vampires, and skeletons. Uthroch was blessed with by gods and given an army of men and animals to destroy the dead. He brought peace and prosperity to the land, growing more powerful as the land improved. Years later, he led the tiny barony against the Camorran usurper and saved all of Tamriel. How much credit the Baron ought to receive for the defeat of the Camorran usurper has been debated, but it is an uncontestable fact that in the year Third Era, 267, the Camorran usurper's relentless move north through Hyrok was halted around the area of contemporary Dwinin. Dwinin is actually larger than it was in the first Baron's day. It did not, in fact, have a seaport, but the Battle of Firewaves was a coastal battle. The fact that the battle probably did not occur in Dwinin does not in itself belittle the Baron's participation in it. The Camorran usurper had conquered Hammerfell and Valenwood by means of a large army, which by legend consisted entirely of undead and Daedra, but was mostly composed of Red Guards and Wood Elves. In all probability, the usurper summoned the Daedra and undead in Orinthia, and slowly replaced the original summoned creatures with the armies of his conquered territories. Most armies of Valenwood have been historically mercenary. Word of the usurper's conquests reached Hyrok in early 266, but preparations to repel the invasion did not begin until early the following year. Historians attribute two factors to Hyrok's hesitancy. The primary powers of the Bay were ruled by particularly inept monarchs. Wayrest and Sentinel both had kings in their minority, and Daggerfall was torn by contention between Helena and her cousin Jalath. The Lord of Ryke Gradkeep, now Anticlare, was deathly ill through 266 and finally died at the end of the year. There were, in short, no leaders to unite the province against the usurper. Of the leaders with any influence, at least eight, the eight traitors of legend, made secret allegiances with the usurper to protect their lands. The secondary reason for the lethargy of Hyrok had to do with the depth of relations between the province and the Septim Empire. For the first time since the beginning of the dynasty, an emperor ruled Tamriel who was neither Breton nor had spent any of his childhood in Hyrok. The difference between Sephorus II and his cousin Uriel IV, who preceded him, was appalling to the people of Hyrok. Even mad emperors like Pelagius III revered the Bretons over all other races, and cousins and younger siblings of the emperors have ruled in Hyrok since the foundation of the empire. Sephorus was a Nord, with Skyrim and Morrowind sympathies. The attitude of the common men of Hyrok was sympathetic toward the Camorran usurper as an arch foe of this hated emperor. The Baron and his less legendary allies, the rulers of Icalan, Phrygia, and Cambria, changed this favorable perception. News of the usurper's barbaric treatment of captives and abuse of conquered lands, mostly true, spread rapidly through their territories and then to other neutral lands. Within a few months, the greatest navy ever combined organized along the Hyrok edge of the Iliac Bay. Only the navy of Uriel V's ill-fated invasion of Akavir was comparable. How the combined forces of Hyrok defeated the endless army of the Camorran usurper is certainly worthy of a lengthy book in itself, and perhaps it is best left to public imagination. Certainly the weather worked against the usurper, which is reason in itself to attribute divine intervention. Baron Othrok's divine purpose is the central theme of Othroktide after all, and as the poet Braylock wrote, to find the facts, the wisest always look first to the fiction. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, The Fall of the Usurper.